Give me justice, O God, and plead my cause against a nation that is faithless. From the deceitful and cunning, rescue me, for you, O God, are my strength.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. By your help, we beseech you, Lord our God, may we walk eagerly in that same charity with which, out of love for the world, your Son handed himself over to death. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, O my people, I will open your graves and have you rise from them and bring you back to the land of Israel. Then you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and have you rise from them, O my people. I will put my spirit in you that you may live. And I will settle upon your land. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. I have promised, and I will do it, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit dwelling in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sent word to Jesus, saying, Master, the one you love is ill. When Jesus heard this, he said, This illness is not to end in death, but is for the glory of God, the Son of God may be glorified through it. Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. So when he heard that he was ill, he remained for 2 days in the place where he was. Then, after this, he said to his disciples, "Let us go back to Judea." When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." He became perturbed and deeply troubled and said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Sir, come and see." And Jesus wept. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not the one who opened the eyes of the blind man have done something so that this man would not have died?" So Jesus, perturbed again, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay across it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the dead man's sister, said to him, "Lord, by now there will be a stench. He has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. And Jesus raised his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always hear me. But because of the crowd here, I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me." And when he had said this, he cried out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, tied hand and foot with burial bands, and his face was wrapped in a cloth. So Jesus said to them, "Untie him and let him go." Now many of the Jews who had come to Mary and seen what he had done began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This beautiful story about Lazarus, which never stops holding our attention when we hear it, captures beautifully, I think, as so often happens in John's Gospel, the humanity and the divinity of Christ at work together. Clearly, the humanity of Christ is evident in the love he had for Lazarus, Martha, and Mary. It's clearly evident in the grief he feels over the death of Lazarus. It's clearly evident in the friendship he shared with the three of them. Yes, we clearly see the humanity of Jesus revealed. At the same time, we see the divine person of Jesus revealed. When Jesus speaks about seeing the glory of God, he means an action that reveals the presence of God in the midst of his people through Jesus, who is and shares in the fullness of divinity through the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes, and this is an opportunity Jesus seizes to invite belief in himself and his power to act. It's interesting that Jesus is criticized by some of the observers. It's comforting to know sometimes that no matter what you do, it's not good enough in some people's eyes, and that was true even for Jesus. And he teaches us the lesson, if criticism is unfair, ignore it and go about your business, which is exactly what Jesus intended to do. And so he goes up, and it's also interesting that people help Jesus in this process. For example, Martha through filling him in and leading him over to the cave. And when he says, Lazarus, come forth, somebody has already removed the stone covering the cave. And when he calls him out, he comes out and he tells people, untie him. So there are people who help in the process of Jesus' performance of this miracle. This revelation of his identity as truly sent by God. That's what it means to reveal the glory of God, that Jesus is of divine origin, and yet he is truly human and truly divine. It's interesting sometimes that we refer to Jesus as human like us. But I remember thinking one day, no, it's Jesus who is the fullness of humanity. Our sinfulness impedes us from acting as truly human. And Jesus had no such imposition. So Jesus alone knows what it's like to be fully human and also, of course, fully divine. Has this story any relevance to the challenges we face today? You all know what they are. Not in my lifetime, and I believe maybe in the history of the world, has a problem so presented itself to all humankind as this coronavirus has done. And in a way, I think we can identify with Lazarus because we're forced to enter the tomb. We're forced to withdraw inside ourselves. We're forced to go into an almost tomb-like posture to protect ourselves. And we have no instant magical solution. We also know that everybody in the world is vulnerable to this, more or less at the same time and over the same period of time. So we need to ask Jesus to come and liberate us from the power of death that this coronavirus has over us. We need to ask Jesus to bless and assist and help all those who helped liberate Lazarus and are helping and working so hard to liberate all those who are sick. So many people are sacrificing their own safety and security to try to bring health and good well-being to others who are in desperate need. Yes, this coronavirus is a tremendous threat, but maybe it's also an opportunity. Jesus saw the loss of Lazarus, which he felt keenly when he wept, as an opportunity to reveal that God was still present and willing to act on those who had faith in him. And so we turn to Jesus and we say, we need you now more than ever. Please liberate us. First of all, help us to think with wisdom and love and understanding. Help us to be as compassionate toward one another as you were toward Martha and Mary over the loss of Lazarus. Help us to comfort, support one another. And yes, accept the challenges we need to in order to come out fully from this tomb. May everything that's preventing us and holding us back be liberated from us, so that we can walk out like Lazarus did, into a new light of day, into a new connection with one another, into the grace and fullness of God's love. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With the Lord there is mercy. In that confidence, we bring our petitions to God.
For the Church, that in proclaiming God as the source of life within us, we may recognize the sanctity of life within us all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that people whose lives are marked by the darkness of pain, suffering, and destruction may come to know the power of Christ's resurrection and the hope the Christ offers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For those preparing for the Easter sacraments, that the faith of the Church inspires and encourages all seeking sacramental communion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering in the current outbreak of sickness, and for all scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who are serving the common good in this difficult time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, that we may roll away the stones that block us from becoming closer to God and assist others in unwrapping the burial bands that hold them in bondage, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For the sick of our parish, that they may experience God's grace and healing touch, especially Sharon Hogan, Chris DiEno, Jackie Coves, Charlie Landers, Mary DiEno, Bohan Minogue, Agnes Gallagher, Julia Kehoe, and all those listed in the bulletin, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Anne Lamort and Dr. Enrico Gonzalez, that they will live forever in the peace of God's eternal love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember in a special way George Kentakis, Vito Kucinich, and Valenti Brzezinska, for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you raised your Son from the dead. Hear our petitions and raise us to new life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our healing with all his holy church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as a true man he wept for Lazarus his friend, and as eternal God raised him from the tomb, just as, taking pity on the human race, he leads us by sacred mysteries to new life. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. By sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, John, our presiding bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day,
that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ in whose body and blood we have communion. We pray through Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Our first announcement is truly the most important, and it is said with great affection. We miss you. We long for the day that we will be gathered around the Lord's table in person. Each day, we are one day closer to when that reality will happen. We will get through this. In the meantime, please be sure to check the parish website on a regular basis for important updates. There are several tabs at the top of the website that we invite you to check out. In addition, we are sending e-blasts to our parishioners. If you believe that we do not have your email address, please contact Krista's email address, is found in the bulletin. Thank you so much for those who have been mailing in their envelopes or dropping them off through the mail slot on the Franklin Lake roadside of the parish center. Thank you also for signing up for online giving, whether it's through Parish Giving, PayPal, or our parish's GoFundMe page. Your weekly financial stewardship funds the necessary day-to-day operations of our parish. God bless you for your continued assistance and support and prayers. And finally, be sure to log on to our website in order to access this week's edition of the bulletin, which has an update on our parish's cleanup, which began this week, and our future rebuild efforts. These are certainly encouraging developments during this time of challenge, and remember, we are always MVS strong.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. Bless, O Lord, your people, who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant that what, at your prompting, they desire, they may receive by your generous gift, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.